Good evening, everybody. I'm back with another week of the Patreon packs for you guys. So throughout the week, you know, one pack card from each pack, the rarest card, will pop up on eBay. And my patrons will get free shipping, and then everyone else can pay my ass to ship it. I'm not going to do that work for free. I do that work for my Patreons. Patrons? Patrons for free, because I love them. I hate everybody else. Okay, so we're off. First pack. This time around, it is Brothers War Draft Boosters, a set that I don't think works very well. Power Stone, Bushwhack, Elsewhere Flask, and Mishra's Foundry. I don't think this is worth anything, is it? Let's see what we got. Yeah, nothing else. That's the one. Nope, that is not on the first page on the price guide, which means it's worth less than a dollar. Really the easy way to tell. Okay. Got a Power Stone, a Bone Saw, and Rushland. Yeah, I don't think any of these are worth anything either, right? There's the Painlands. Rushland, yeah, dollar. Yep, there you go. Pack number 50. Let's see, Forest. Adaptive Automaton. And Autonomous Assembler. Let's see, either of those. Adaptive is not there. How's Autonomous? Nope, neither of them are there. Oh no, wait, I gotta look on that. See, this is one of the other annoying things. It's not one price list, it's actually five price lists? Four. You got Brothers War, Brothers War Retro Frames, Brothers War Extras, and Universes Beyond Transformers. You have four different price guides for the cards in this pack, just so it can be more annoying. Okay, so Retro Frames, is Autonomous any good? No, it is not. There you go. So another dud of a pack. Sorry, guys. I am striking out. Come on. Let me get something good. Like, what do I want? I mean, I want Mox Amber Schematics. That's probably the realest card I can get. A foil schematic, whatever. Boom, Golem, Island, Ivory Tower, and Deja Digsite Mentor. Don't think this is anything. What is this? Is that, Nope, worthless. Let me see. Nope, Mentor is not on the list. Not there. Another bum-ass pack. One good card. Maybe one thing that's gonna give y'all a little something-something. Okay, Zephyr Sentinel, Lodestone Golem Schematic, and Land of War Wastes, like another, maybe a dollar, you know, which you guys can get for a penny, right? No one else is gonna bid against you because of the shipping fee. So you're basically, you know, whatever. That's the gift I give to my patrons, is every day you're basically gonna get a rare card for a penny. Okay. We got a nothing card, a Jollum Tome, and Perennial Behemoth. You may play lands from your graveyard. Interesting. I don't know. Is that anything? Let me see. Behemoth. Are you here? Nope, you are not. Nope, not there. Man, this really is just about the worst seven packs I've ever opened. I don't think a single one of these cards is going to crack $2. Jollum Tome and Gix. Wait, did I just do it? Is this the real deal? There we go. Okay, last pack I got to hit. This is it. This is Gix, Yawgmouth Praetor. Let's see. I'm going to look this guy up on MTG stock. And this seems to have a pretty steady value. So this came out about $15, $15 to $20. It's still in the $15 to $20 range, which gives me a sense that its value, the standard card's value, is actually reasonable and based on gameplay. Whenever a creature deals combat damage to one of your opponents, its controller may pay one life, and if they do, they draw a card. Interesting. Okay, whenever... See, this is weird, because for me, I only play, like, standard games. Like, you know, one-on-ones with me and my friends. We do best of threes, and we do drafts and jumpstart tournaments and stuff like that. But I never do commander, and we never do four-player games. But this right here is weird. Whenever a creature deals combat damage to one of your opponents, its controller may pay one life. that becomes so much more complicated of an ability in a multiplayer game, right? Whenever a creature deals combat damage to one of your... And now all of a sudden, this applies to the other two guys. Or the other three people, right? Whenever a creature deals combat damage to one of your opponents. Yeah. That gets weird. So, in a one-on-one game, that's real easy to meta, like, to, you know, theory craft around. But, oof. Feels like you're giving that to all of your... Like... Yeah, you're giving, you know, the other two players the same ability. Okay, discard X cards. Exile the top X cards of target opponent's library. And they play lands and cast spells from there. Okay. Intriguing. I like this. No wonder. This is one of those terrible exile decks where it takes all of my stuff away and then you use them. Terrifying. Okay, there you go. Got a hit there right at the end. One more week of pub packs for you guys. There you go. Enjoy. Have a good one. Good night. Godspeed. Praise Gix.